The Bible showed us in verse 6 that the people came and they rose up against God's leader. And after the acknowledgement, when they saw that they were being attacked by snakes and many were dying, they acknowledged that they said, "We sinned."
Mm-hmm. Yes.
We had sinned.
Yes.
How did we sin? Simple as this. Because we spoke against Moses,
yes,
the Lord, and we spoke against Moses,
yes,
the messenger.
Yes.
So it shows you, the word of God has shown us,
yes,
that it's a sin,
amen,
to touch God's anointing.
Amen.
And to touch the provision and every plans of God over our lives and what he's spoken. It's a sin to touch the word and try to take away and add from it. It's a sin.
Yes.
It's a sin to undermine, try to undermine the word of God,
Jesus,
and what God has already said to his people. Tell your neighbor, beware.
Lift them up.
The Bible said, I just want to more and more live this in your spirit because it's such a powerful word for this time. John 12 and 32 says, "And I, if I be lifted up, I will draw all men unto me." Why was the Lord lifted up in the wilderness in the form of a serpent? It is that he was lifted up in the wilderness in the form of a serpent. It showed, it was symbolizing that Jesus will die in like manner.
Yes.
And he will be lifted up on the cross in like manner.
Jesus.
And man will be drawn
to him.
Mm-hmm. Deliverance will take place. Man will be saved. Even as the Son of Man be lifted up. I hear the Lord God say, as he went through all of the process, just for all of us as we are existing here in the land of the living, to more and more lift him up. You've already gone through the process, the lifting up of the cross and died and they stretch him right by. But I come up with a revelation right now, so I'll show you a lot of devils just didn't understand what he was up against.
My God.
But the Lord showed me, he said, in the midst, as the church, the job of the church now, you and I, is more and more to magnify God, to unveil him to the earth, to tell others about him. To be witnesses of him, to be true disciples. As we do that, we are lifting him up. We are exalting him. We are praising him. We are making man and humanity and mankind to know that, hey, no other savior, no other way but the way, the truth, and the life.
Yes.
No man come unto my God, to the Father, except through Jesus the Son. He's the way, he's the truth, and the life. He's the door.
Yes.
And as we tell and encourage others to be drawn to him,
mm-hmm,
he's lifted up. We're not worrying and complaining about what we don't have from what we have.
Mm.
We're content, yes, because we know who we are and whose we are.
Amen.
We have been called to be the light of the world.
Mm.
We are the church.
Yes.
And so the light got to shine. Mm-hmm. And as we shine and we make persons them around the world realm, know that darkness cannot exist when light comes. Christ has came. So we are the light and he is in us, the hope of glory. And so more and more we allow him to be revealed in this earth, the more and more his name will be exalted and lifted up high. And indeed, his kingdom will manifest upon us. What is the kingdom of God? The kingdom of God is the full power and the essence of the tree of Godhead, Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost. The full power of God, the existence, the power of his might, the power of his glory.
Yes.
Manifest into earth in us. The kingdom of God is among us. And so let's continue to lift Jesus up. As I go